Hey guys, it's Giovanni. I've been able to spend several weeks with the 360 Fly video camera, and just like the company says, it does give you the power to capture content in fully immersive, interactive 360 HD video. Well, kind of. It's actually 240 degrees, but we can give credit to the marketing department for that little tiny embellishment. Now, along with this camera, the manufacturer also supplies you with tools necessary to edit and do small enhancements to your video and then share your videos across social media. So the big question is this camera ready for prime time? And should you run out and buy one today? So I've got to admit it, I was pretty smitten with the appearance of the 360 Fly the first time that I saw it. It looks a little bit like a golf ball, but the design decisions made by some of its competitor allows the 360 Fly to stand out as a camera meant to not get in the way or to make a spectacle of itself. Now, this might seem like a small thing, but when you want to shoot things like music festivals or shoot documentaries or capture footage without your subjects being distracted by the gear that you're using, having a bunch of big yellow squares or several of these, you know, on a stage or a set, it's pretty much a deal killer for me right out of the box. And sure, I can whip out gaff tape and I can cover the camera up, and I've actually done that in a few cases, but why does a company make videographers do that in the first place? The 360 Fly has got an arsenal of connectivity that would delight any mobile content creator, and a housing that is extremely resistant. It's able to protect the camera from liquids and minor blows, and to prove it, I took it on 2 3-day outdoor music festivals, a college basketball game, and a shoot at a factory out in the Midwest. The 360 Fly is a panoramic video camera which comes equipped with everything you need to capture the most exciting moments of your sports, your hobbies, travels, or whatever you want to point this thing at. Now, apart from its hard shockproof shell, it's also resistant to extreme temperature changes, which makes it critical when you want to shoot things like, you know, skiing or things like that, or if you want to take it out into the heat, which I've done on a lot of shoots with other cameras. You can also take it underwater, which is an option that gives you the possibility of capturing great underwater footage when you're surfing or snorkeling or doing activities that are kind of based around water. You don't have to worry about this thing getting wet and getting ruined. The 360 Fly is waterproof to 5 meters with nothing other than a small cap being put on it to protect the microphone. The mounts on the 360 Fly are compatible with accessories from GoPro, which is something that the likes of Kodak and other manufacturers either didn't have the foresight to do or, and I hope this isn't the case, chose not to do in order to specifically force consumers to have to reinvest in accessories for their specific camera. It's these kinds of decisions which makes me personally root for, say, one company over another. Now, when you're ready to take the 360 Fly out and start doing some shooting, you have several mounting options. Now, it's obviously compatible with any tripod, and it incorporates various brackets and fixtures and doodickies and things like that, but the adhesives are great for attaching to helmets or, in my case, on stage rigging. It's small and light, weighing only 120 grams, and it allows you to place it almost anywhere without drawing attention to itself. In my mind, the design of the 360 Fly makes it stand out well above its competitors. There are a couple of other 360 cameras that I'm waiting to get my hands on to review, which either haven't made it production yet, or in one case, I haven't tested the Ricoh Theta S yet because, well, it's just impossible to get a hold of. But compared to what's available on the market right now, things that I've had in my hands, well, the 360 Fly wins on design alone. And that's not just because of aesthetics. The design of this camera makes it integrate into production situations more effectively than any other 360 camera that I've touched so far. So how does this work? The 360 Fly has an ultra-wide angle of view, 240 degrees vertically, a spherical lens, and records in full HD. The optic specs include an ultra fisheye lens composed of 8 elements, which has an f2.5 aperture, a 0.8 millimeter focal length, and a minimal focusing distance of 30 centimeters. It connects to any phone or tablet with Android or iOS with its own 360 Fly app. Now, the app gives you live view of what you're about to record, but at the time of this shooting of this video, you cannot live view what the camera is actually seeing when it's in recording mode in real time. That's a mouthful. You can't edit videos from the iPhone or tablet and even share them on social media. There's also a desktop app named the 360 Director, but we're going to have to talk about that in a later video. So what else do we have? Well, the 360 Fly uses Bluetooth and Wi-Fi to connect to your phone or tablet and has a very easy-to-use interface. The camera's hardware includes 32 gigabytes of internal memory, USB for charging and transferring videos to your desktop, a capable built-in microphone, a 1600 milliamp lithium battery that the manufacturer says supports 2 consecutive hours of recording, but that I was constantly able to get 2 hours and 30 minutes or more out of, an image stabilizer, which you will see is very useful in reducing vibration and unwanted movements when you see the video I shot of the camera mounted on top of my rental car, an accelerometer, LED lights that indicate what the camera is doing, and a whole lot more. There's several reviews on this camera which are lukewarm in tone. Now, while the camera isn't currently shooting GoPro 4 Black quality video, neither did the first GoPro. But when that came out, I quickly grabbed 4 of them and started putting them to work. Limitations and all, I'd suggest that you do the same with the 360 Fly. You're buying a first generation consumer level 360 degree action camera here. I'd suggest you get it and start learning how to shoot compelling video with it. Don't let the tech spec whiners keep you from being a trailblazer. This camera does very well when you shoot in full sunlight and is still very capable in some low light situations. Outside of that, it opens the door to a very exciting new method of video that any storyteller that's worth their salt is going to have to master if they plan on being a leader in their local market in 2 to 3 years. This is no different than the previously mentioned GoPros, or actually drones of today. The first DJI Phantom was pretty terrible. Now, and this is amazing to think about, less than 2 years after the release of the first Phantom, we're already on multiple versions of the third generation of the Phantoms. The DJI Inspire at less than $3,000 is amazing, and there's also a host of other very capable competitors in that space. 360 degree video will be no different. So the 360 Fly video action camera, it's available today at your local Best Buy. It's about $400. I'd suggest you run out and get one.